Good, Dylan.
Yeah.
And the adoption of the meeting agenda has been put before you, and we also have one additional request at the E-911 director's request, reference to the director's presence at the quarterly advisory meeting. Without exception, that will be added under new business, which includes the to announce that the next meeting of the E-911 advisory board will be at a date to be determined in the second quarter of 2012. A motion is in order that the agenda be adopted. Do I hear such a motion?
Chief, do you have a copy of the agenda?
We do. Yes, sir.
For the
yes, sir.
Can we get some copies, some extra copies?
Yes. Yes, sir. Chief of Police comes, we have another chair. You're welcome to have a seat.
Thank you. Actually, most of the times I stand while I'm filming, but thank you very much.
Have a seat. Printed agenda will now be laid before you.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome.
Is there a motion to adopt the agenda?
So moved.
Do I hear a second? Discussion, hearing none, all in favor of adopting the agenda, please signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
All opposed? Show the agenda is adopted. The minutes of the May the 23rd, 2011 advisory board meeting were sent out, and does anyone note any errors or omissions in the minutes as presented? Hearing none, motion is in order to adopt the minutes of the May the 23rd, 2011 advisory board meeting.
So moved.
Second.
Discussion. All in favor of the motion, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Item 6, old business. Is there old business to bring before the board? Hearing none, we move to item 7, new business, and that is to announce that the next meeting of the E-911 advisory board will be at a date to be determined in the second quarter of 2012, April, May, or June. We will send that out to you as required by law, and it will be posted. An addition to the agenda of today, as shown in your adopted agenda, is the E-911 director has requested to address the board relative to the resolution by the Board of Commissioners creating and organizing the Emergency 911 Advisory Board. The last sentence of the fourth paragraph reads, "The current 911 director shall serve as an advisory, non-voting, ex officio member of the board. and shall be present at all meetings. Ms. Giordano, the floor is yours.
My request is that that be revised to say that I can have a representative, either myself or my designee, be present. And that designee would normally be the assistant director. But there's some, I don't want to limit the time of the meetings because I couldn't be here.
I think that's appropriate. Maybe a list of who your designees could be.
Okay.
I mean, we, you know, like you said, your assistant director, or if there's a deputy assistant director, or, you know,
okay,
certainly someone in the higher up ranks of your department. I think the top two or three would be
acceptable.
Appropriate.
Okay.
Sure. That's just one commissioner's opinion.
Mr. Dare, under item 5 of the resolution by the Board of Commissioners that organizes the 911 Advisory Board, it reads, "The Forsyth County Manager shall have final authority and governance over the Forsyth County 911 Center Advisory Board in any of its recommendations, assistance, and services. The Forsyth County Manager is hereby empowered to act upon or decline to act upon any recommendations, direction provided by the advisory board." With that statement being made, do you see that this change would have to go back before the Board of Commissioners by way of the county attorney, or do you have such authority to make the change that's been suggested?
I'm not sure that I have the authority to do that. I think if this board deems this change necessary, and I agree that it is necessary, then I would be glad to take this back to the board to amend the resolution that was adopted, of which what you just read. So I'd be glad to take it back to the board and ask them to amend the resolution.
Commissioner Tam, would you restate your motion, please?
Well, I would make the motion that we present back to the Forsyth County Board of Commissioners a suggested list of names that could sit in for the 911 director at these meetings.
Motion is made. Do I hear a second?
Second.
Discussion.
I think it's perfectly appropriate, and obviously her job requires off-site training, right?
Yes, sir.
And this is a full-time job for her. She has a schedule.
And I'll state for the record, it's my understanding you canceled some airline tickets to be here today, and we appreciate that very much. Let the record show that. Motion's on the floor and duly seconded. Any further discussion? All in favor of the motion, please vote by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion is passed and adopted. I will work with you, Mr. Dare, so that we might take this through to fruition.
Okay, thank you.
There is no other business to come before this board as advertised today that has been placed. There is a motion in order for adjournment. Do I hear such a motion?
Second.
Motion is made and seconded. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, nay. It's down and dirty, Doctor. Sorry. That's the way we do it. God bless you all. Have a nice day.
Thank you, Chief.
Thank you. Thank you, Ms. Tisdale.
Thank you, Chief. Thank you very much.
Would you like to sit downstairs? Do you have a minute? I'll be happy to show you.
Doctor, you're welcome for any time.
Thank you.
Thank you for taking your time.
My pleasure.
Thank you.
Pat, thank you.
Thank you.
Commissioner Pike.
Pat, do I leave this morning?
You make yourself at home, Ms. Tisdale.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
She's your charge.
Yes.